It was instant tears. He was a good man.
George Voinovich was Cleveland mayor, Ohio governor, and U.S. senator. But above all, he was a man of the people. He will always be remembered for the great things that he did, but he will be cherished for the little things that made people love him.
I used to belong to this church, and I would see him at Mass on Sundays. Mm-hmm. And he just seemed like an ordinary person.
He even came to the park, like when the girls were in softball, mm-hmm. Howland Park for the little parade. Mm-hmm. Not too many people do that. Not too many mayors do that.
Folks gathered outside of Our Lady of the Lake Catholic Church Friday to share a story or a memory of their neighbor and friend, a way of showing respect, but also a way to say, thank you, George.
I want them to know this is how you honor someone that you care about and love and respect and that has done a lot for you and your country to make your world better when you grow up.
The 79-year-old died Sunday morning in his Collinwood home. He is survived by his beloved wife, Janet, three children and many, many grandchildren. A fourth child, their youngest daughter, Molly, died back in 1979 in a tragic accident. And as services ended, people from all walks of life, all different politics, races, and beliefs lined the streets of the church. This was the true power of George Voinovich. He kept things simple and direct, but he knew how to bring all people together.
At a time when Cleveland was in default, at a time at which, a lot of people thought that Cleveland's best days were behind her, he didn't believe that. He believed you could pull people together. He was the ultimate optimist.
If George would ever want anything, he used to use that slogan, together we can do it, or something like that. And that's what we did. We all worked together because we were kids from Cleveland who loved the city.